नमस्कार चिल्ड्रन, वी हैव स्टार्टेड आवर चैप्टर नंबर 3, बिजनेस एनवायरनमेंट एंड द मीनिंग एज वेल एज द फीचर्स ऑफ द बिजनेस एनवायरनमेंट वी हैव ऑलरेडी डिस्कस्ड। टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू स्टार्ट विद द डायमेंशन और द कंपोनेंट्स और द फैक्टर्स कॉन्स्टिट्यूटिंग बिजनेस एनवायरनमेंट। सो फर्स्ट वी सी दैट वट इज द डायमेंशन। डायमेंशंस ऑफ बिजनेस एनवायरनमेंट मीन्स ऑल द फैक्टर्स, forces and institutions which have direct or indirect influence over the business activities. This definition we have already discussed. Now here direct and indirect influences we'll see. In this diagram you can see that firm is there, and in the pink box the organization, competitors, suppliers, intermediaries, customers and market is there, and these all generally forms the micro environment of the business. And in the blue box you can see demographic, economic, technological, cultural, government, political and legal. These terms are related with the macro environment of any business. So first we see that what are the dimensions which are there in our syllabus. These five dimensions: economic environment, social environment, legal environment, technological environment and political environment. These five dimensions are there in our syllabus. So these dimensions I'm going to start today. So the first dimension is economic environment. So the first thing which we see in this, that is that what is the meaning of the term. So it consists of economic factors that influence the business of a country. It include factors such as inflation, tax and interest rates, unemployment, fiscal and monetary policies. These all combine and make economic environment. So broad economic characteristics in which a business enterprise operates is known as the economic environment of business. Short and long term interest rates significantly affect the demand for product and services. Now here one example is given that after the new economic policy which was introduced in the year 1991, a lot of opportunities are offered to businessman, as well as in case of construction companies and automobile manufacturers, low longer term rates are beneficial because they result in increased spending by consumers for buying homes and cars on borrowed money. Similarly, a rise in the disposable income of people due to increase in the gross domestic product of a country, it creates increasing demand for products. High inflation rates generally result in constraints on business enterprises as they increase the various cost of business, such as the purchase of raw materials or machinery and payment of wages and salaries to employees. So this is the first dimension, that is economic environment. Now the second environment is social environment. It describes the feature of the society in which the business organization exists. Social environment consists of religious aspects, language, customs, traditions, beliefs, taste, preference, consumption habit, etc. And the social environment varies from market to market. So we can say that social environment of a business refers to the broad characteristics of the society in which a business enterprise operates. It includes the social forces like customs, traditions, values, social trends, the expectation of society from business. For example, Indian women are increasingly engaging themselves in business, profession and employment. For example, the celebration of Diwali, Eid, Christmas in India provides significant financial opportunities for greeting card companies, sweets or confectionery manufacturers, and many other related businesses. Social trends present various opportunities and threats to business enterprises. One more example we can take in this context, the health and fitness trend has created a demand for products like organic food, diet soft drinks, gyms, mineral water, and food supplements. This trend has, however, harmed the business in other industries like dairy processing and all. The next third dimension is political environment. It is the outcome of a combination of various ideologies advocated by various political parties. It includes political conditions such as general stability and peace in the country and the political attitude of the elected government towards business. So it refers to the broad characteristics of political system in which the business enterprise operates. Political environment includes political conditions such as general stability and peace. So the significance of political conditions in business success lies in the predictability of business activities under stable political conditions. On the other hand, there may be uncertainty of business activities due to political unrest and threats to law and order. So the political stability builds up confidence among business people to invest in the long-term projects for the growth of the economy. Political instability can shake that confidence. For example, even after opening up of our economy in 1991, foreign companies found it extremely difficult to cut through the bureaucratic red tapism to get permits for doing business in India. Sometimes it took months to process even their application for the purpose. As a result, these companies were discouraged from investing in our country. But the situation has improved over time. The next dimension is technological environment. It includes forces relating to scientific improvements and innovations, which provide new products, new production method, and new methods of operating a business. For example, companies introduce new models of car time to time, introduction of online trading system, introduction of net banking, etc. So, the technological environment of a business refers to the broad characteristics of technology in which the business enterprise operates. It includes forces relating to scientific improvements. So we can take the example, the recent technological advances are there in the computers, electronics, the way in which companies advertise their products. It is common now to see CD-ROMs, computerized informations, kiosk system, World Wide Web, multimedia pages, highlighting the virtues of products. So these are the simple examples of the technological environment. The last dimension is legal environment. It consists of the legal framework within which the business has to function, including legislation passed by the government, administration orders, court judgment, and so on. So, legal environment of a business refers to the broad characteristics of the legislation in which a business enterprise operates. Here some of the examples are given that advertisement for packets of cigarette must carry the statutory warning, cigarette smoking is injurious to health. Every management is required to obey the law of land. Non-compliance of laws can lead into legal problems. Legal environment consists of legislation that has been passed by the Parliament and state legislatures like Consumer Protection Act 1986, Competition Act 2002, administrative orders issued by government authorities, court judgments, as well as the decisions rendered by various commissions and agencies at every level of the government, means the central, state or local. So these are the five environments. Now one more term is there, that is the environment scanning. Now here we see that what is the meaning of this term. It can be defined as a process by which organizations monitor their relevant information environment to identify opportunities and threats affecting the business. Means which kind of opportunities are there in the market which can be grabbed by the business, and which kind of problems, which kind of threats are available. So those threats, to fight with those threats, the company can make prepare itself. This is known as the environment scanning. Now do the case studies related with the topic which is already assigned to you in the worksheet, and read the importance of business environment. In the next virtual session, we'll continue with the same. Thank you.